Hi there, this is Pastor Jeff, and this is Articulate Truth. Today I'd like to resume our study of the Sermon on the Mount found in the Gospel of Matthew, the chapters 5, 6, and 7. Today we're actually going to go to chapter 7 in the first verse, and the Word of God says this: don't condemn others, and God won't condemn you. God will be as hard on you as you are on others. He will treat you exactly as you treat them. Wow. You know, it's understandable by why this sermon that Jesus gave just revolutionized life. It revolutionized people's concept of God, people's concept of their relationship to each other, and there's a reason for it to be his most famous sermon, because he continually said things that just rocked people's world. In this statement, even as a person who has followed the Lord my entire life, when I read it in this context, that God will be as hard on me as I am on other people, and he will treat me exactly as I treat other people. Jesus was really, really, really trying to get to a point here. He was really hard on people who thought that somehow they were better than other people. He was really hard on people who thought that certain people should be treated as less than. He was most hard on people who were supposed to be the people representing God and representing God's word, who took on this attitude that some people were beneath them, were less than them. And Jesus wanted to just take that horrible, terrible, bigoted, prejudice idea and smash it to smithereens and make them realize that God is going to treat you how you treat others. God's going to give you your own medicine. He's going to think of you and treat you as harshly as you treat others. Wow, Jesus. Really? We are so accustomed to thinking of God, the one who gave his only begotten Son, the one who is so merciful and so forgiving, so gracious and tender, and he is that way. It's really hard for us to think God saying, I'm going to treat you just as you treat other people. I'm going to give it to you just like you give it to them. He's trying to teach a point that there are no hires and lowers. There's no better people than other people. In fact, when you really think about what Jesus was trying to drill into our hearts, was that we are a family. We are a brotherhood, a sisterhood, that we all come from the same Heavenly Father. In fact, it was so revolutionary when he taught us to pray, "Our Father in heaven." Not Almighty God who's out there somewhere. Abba, Daddy, Father. And every single person on this planet is our brother, is our sister. And we need to treat them with equity, with equality, with sameness, love for all, grace for all, forgiveness for all, without any kind of judgment, condemnation. Now, not everyone is to be trusted. We've talked about that. But everyone is to be loved. And we need to treat people like we want to be treated. In fact, Jesus really brought that home with the statement that he made in the same passage in chapter 7 of Matthew, verse 12. I'm sure you've heard this. Treat others as you want them to treat you. This is what the law and the prophets are all about. Jesus summarized the entire writing of all the scriptures that every person had ever known up until that moment. He says, listen, everything that I have declared from Mount Sinai, everything that every man that I have ever sent to prophesy, it all comes down to us treating others the way that we want them to treat us. We've learned it from the time we were children. It's called the Golden Rule. Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. This is the old King James approach to it. It's the same words. It's the same heart. It's the same heart of the Father. I want you to treat each other the same way you want to be treated. Don't treat them less than you. Don't ever treat them less than you. Treat them with the same grace that I freely extend to you. You know, it's a pretty simple message. I think it'll take a lifetime for us to learn to do it. And unfortunately, we battle. We still battle with finding reasons to separate, to distinguish. Because of somebody being different in some way, we actually treat them as if they're different. And that's not the heart of the Father at all. So, just encourage you today, open up your heart one more time to embrace what the Word of God is all about. It's treating people the same way you want them to treat you. Without judgment, without condemnation, with the same kind of love and grace that you expect the Father to give to you. Well, He expects you to give that to everyone else. Can I pray with you today? Heavenly Father, I thank you for this word, this mind-breaking, culture-destroying concept. That a culture that would cause people to be segregated and divided, that cause people to make people less than them for whatever petty, crazy, ridiculous reason. May we come back to the beginning, to the very beginning, to what your word has always been about. Treat others as you would like for them to treat you. Lord, may that simple golden rule, may it really be that. May it be our rule. May it be the pattern of our mind and our heart. And we see that person that we don't quite understand and that we don't immediately relate to. May we choose to see them the way you see them, and may we reach out with the kind of kindness and compassion and tenderheartedness and receiving, embracing, loving attitude and behavior that we would want for them to extend to us. So Lord, we thank you for this word. We ask you to seal it in our hearts, to release it in our minds, and it have it walk out in the way that we live our lives. It's our prayer today in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. Thank you for watching. I hope you have a really great day.